Hey everybody, welcome to the start of a new weekly reading vlog. It's actually already Wednesday. I didn't film anything on Monday or Tuesday, mostly because I'm in a bit of a reading crisis. Okay, that sounds a bit more dramatic than it actually is, but yeah, the gist of it is that for the past 2 days, I had no idea what I wanted to read. Like, I won't call it a reading slump because 2 days isn't a slump. But I was just very indecisive about what I wanted to read. Even with audiobooks. Normally with audiobooks, I always find the next one pretty easily. And I always know what I want to listen to next. But now I tried out like 5 different audiobooks. And I just could not decide on which one I wanted to listen to. None of them felt completely right. But after a while, I decided to do another audiobook reread. Because I thought that would be better to do a reread through audiobook, because then I can get back into the audiobook listening mode, hopefully. But I decided to listen to Clockwork Angel by Cassandra Clare. This is the first book in the Infernal Devices series. And yeah, as you might know, as you probably know, next month, in about a month's time, I guess. Yeah, it's in March. The sequel series to the Infernal Devices trilogy is coming out. So with the first book, Chain of Gold, in the Lost Hour series, which is... yeah, it takes place after the Infernal Devices series, so I thought it would be perfect time to do a reread of this series because I loved it very much, and it has been a little more than a year since I read it. I think it's almost 2 years now. Wait, yeah, I think around 2 years. I'm honestly like, that can't be right. It can't be 2 years, but it is, because Queen of Air and Darkness is more than a year ago, and I did an entire reread of all the Shadowhunter books, and I started with the Infernal Devices at the beginning of 2018, so whoa, that feels just so much longer than I thought it was. But yeah, it has been 2 years since I read this. Whoa, that still doesn't feel right, but yeah. Desperate time of a reread. And yeah, I'm listening to the audiobook for the very first time. The first 2 times that I read it was with like the physical copy. But yeah, now I'm listening to the audiobook, which is really nice. And as I mentioned before, I know this story, I love this story, so I think this is a good way to get back into the audiobook vibe. So far it's going well because I've been listening to it for a day and I'm now at page 143. So yeah, that's probably a good idea that I decided to listen to this one. So I'm going to do a reread of the entire Infernal Devices series in February, and then I'm all ready and prepared for Chain of Gold. So yeah, that's my plan for right now with audiobooks. So I'm set for a little while whilst I'm listening to these 3 books. And yeah, what can I say? I really love it. Clockwork Angel is a really good book. And well, it's just one of my favorite young adult books. Don't really have anything else to say about it. I guess the premise, if you don't know, this takes place in Victorian England, and it's about Shadowhunters and a woman named Tessa Gray who gets involved with the Shadowhunters. And yeah, I don't want to say much more about it, but if you love the Shadowhunter books, you will definitely love Clockwork Angel. But if you love the Shadowhunter books, I guess you've probably already read it. So that's it for the audiobook. And then for my physical book, there was also a bit of a dilemma. But for now, I have decided to stick with my reread of The Hunger Games. So yeah, another reread of one of my all-time favorite series. Lots of rereads right now, but I guess that's just the best way to go if you're not completely feeling it when it comes to reading. So I barely read anything of it, by the way. I just read like around 20 pages or so. So really not that much. And I'm not sure if I'm going to read this in one go, or maybe just pick it up every once in a while in between other books. For now, I'm going to stick with it for at least today, and then hopefully get back into the reading vibe. I just want to have my amazing reading mood back. And it's not like I don't have an amazing reading mood right now. I still very much have the reading vibe, but I felt it sort of slipping away, and I don't want that, you know? I want to be in this very good reading mood because I have so many amazing books on my TBR, but somehow I just wasn't feeling it with any of the books. So I'm sticking to rereads for now, and yeah, hopefully that will get me back into the vibe. And also, I'm so happy to be reading this new edition of The Hunger Games with like the new cover. The text, of course, is the same. But yeah, very happy to be reading my beautiful new copy. And then yeah, after that, I'm also maybe this week I will, if I'm feeling it, I will start my read of The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White. This is the book of the Midtake Reads book club. It's the book of February and March. And yeah, I also want to read it this month because I'm participating in Midtake Reads. And I don't know, maybe I will pick this up later this week. I'm not completely sure. I'm so indecisive with picking out my next book at the moment. And this one is a retelling of the King Arthur legend, but told from the eyes of Guinevere. And she's also someone in disguise. So sounds very interesting. Definitely something very different. And yeah, I also want to get on with this one this week, but I'm just going to see how I feel. It's, yeah, I'm very vague and weird right now when it comes to reading, so I'm sorry for this very weird start of a reading vlog. By the way, I was also very happy to see that you guys really liked my bookstore vlog of like when I went shopping last week in Amsterdam and going to Waterstones. So far the reactions have been very positive, and yeah, I'm going to try to do it more whenever I can, but as I mentioned in that video as well, I'm not going book shopping every week. I don't go to bookstores every week or even every month, so yeah, but I'm going to try to include it as much as possible. I'm very happy that you guys like to see sort of like you know, the bookstore but also the surroundings, and you know, I can understand that it might be interesting to see someone in a different country, because of course I live in the Netherlands and most people that watch my videos don't. So yeah, I will try to give you a glimpse every once in a while in my life and what I do, but yeah, this week doesn't seem very promising when it comes to that, because I'm just going to work on school the entire week and that's all I'm going to do. So yeah, my desk looks like a normal desk, not really that interesting. But I was very pleased with all the reactions, so I'm very happy that you liked it. I'm going to try to do it more in the future. Hey everyone, today I'm going to the university library to work on some school stuff. Yeah, I've said this like in many reading vlogs before, and it's just the same old, as always, just going to my university, to the library, to work there. And yeah, also today it's like a beautiful, beautiful sunny day, so that's really nice. It makes it a lot more nice to go outside, you know, and yeah, just some sunshine is always really nice to feel a bit better, I guess. And then both my rereads are still going great. I'm still listening to Clockwork Angel on the audiobook, or like listen to the audiobook, and I'm now about halfway through the book, so I'm going through it quite quickly. But yeah, it's a reread that I love very much, so that it's not like difficult to get through it. So I'm very happy that this got me out of my audiobook slump. Well, not really a slump, but that this one really caught my attention when so many other audiobooks didn't somehow. So I'm very happy that I got back into it, and yeah, just really enjoying it, and I cannot wait for the rest of the series. It's just going to be so much fun to be rereading them, and then the next book, or like the Chain of Gold book, the next series, oh, it's just going to be amazing. I'm so excited for it. And also, The Hunger Games is still going great. I'm now at page 112, and yeah, I really, really enjoy my reread of this as well, like so much. Actually, a lot more than I had expected, because of course I knew I was going to love it, because I love The Hunger Games. But somehow I'm enjoying it so, so much more than I had thought, because I started reading it and I fell into the story immediately. And it just feels like, not like reading the first time again, but it feels like coming home to one of my favorite stories. And I really enjoy that. So I'm really enjoying this reread. So I'm going to finish this reread before I start another book, I have now decided. And then I don't know if I'm going to do like the monthly Hunger Games read along, where you read one Hunger Games book each month, or if I'm going to continue with the series very soon. So that's all going to be decided in the future. But for now, I'm really enjoying The Hunger Games. Also, the first book is my favorite, like the first Hunger Games book has always been my favorite. So yeah, I love it so much. There's a reason that this is one of my all-time favorite book series. It's just so timeless, I feel. It ages so well, it still holds up very well, and I still love it very much. So yeah, very much enjoying it. And then now it's time for me to catch my train and go outside and go to the library, and yeah, hopefully I can have a very productive day. It is now Saturday, and I've been actually having a very productive week. I feel good about myself this week. Somehow things are going smoothly and a lot better than they have gone in the past couple of weeks, at least with like things that I need to do. Reading has been good as always, but like all the other stuff. So I'm very happy with that, very pleased with it. It has been amazing weather throughout the week. I feel like sunshine just helps you feel more productive and more motivated. And it was really nice. I really enjoyed the sun, even though it wasn't really warm or anything. I don't mind. I just really liked that it was sunny and it felt so nice outside. Emphasis on felt, because today it isn't all that great weather. And tomorrow, apparently, there's going to be a storm, which I also like, because storms are really nice if you don't have to be outside. So yeah, not much sunshine anymore, but that's okay. I've had enough for this week. And also, like, reading has been going great. I am still busy with my reread of The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins, and I'm loving it so, so much. Like, I'm devouring this reread. It's just amazing. I have reread The Hunger Games countless times, but I feel like this is one of my favorite rereads ever. It's just, I'm enjoying it so much. The story and the characters and everything, even though I already know them and I already know everything about it. It feels so much better this time around, almost like the first time, even though it's not the first time, of course. But yeah, I read a lot of it last night. I'm now almost done. I'm at page 347, so I'm going to finish it today, that's for certain. Don't know what I'm going to read after that. I think probably The Guinevere Deception or maybe Catching Fire. Who knows? I'm not completely sure, but I will keep you updated. And it also makes me so excited for the prequel. Like, I cannot wait. It's going to be amazing. I know, I just know it. Yeah, just one of my favorite rereads ever. I don't know why, but I'm really, really digging it. And I'm also still rereading Clockwork Angel on audiobook by Cassandra Clare. Also really enjoying it, but I will say that this reread is a little bit less just amazing as the reread of The Hunger Games, but it's perfectly fine, you know? It's okay. I really like it. I do really like the audiobook, and I think with this series I really like the characters and the relationships the most, so that is something that I'm really enjoying at the moment. Also, I've just finished filming a Shadowhunter related video that I filmed because of Chain of Gold coming almost out, and I'm very happy with how it turned out, and I think I'm going to edit it in just a minute, and then I have that done, which is nice. Really excited for all the amazing new releases this year. I hadn't thought about Chain of Gold that much either, because it's the start of a new series. So with that, I can be patient. If it's like the, you know, continuation of a series, as with Queen of Air and Darkness, I was so impatient for that one because I wanted to know how it was going to end. But with Chain of Gold, I have no idea what's going to happen and what the series is going to be, so I'm not that impatient yet, but I'm very, very curious and like so ready for a new Shadowhunter series. So yeah, so many amazing books coming out this year. I'm very excited. That's going to be so much fun. I love books so much. I'm very happy today. I feel nice today. Yeah, I think now I'm going to read, edit, do some other things. That's my plan for today. Hey everybody, it is definitely time for me to give you some reading updates because I finished two books. First of all, it probably won't come as a surprise at this point, but I finished The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins, and oh, I loved it so much. As I mentioned before, I really enjoyed this reread so much. I had the best time reading it. It felt like, it's just, I remembered why I love this book series so much. And I'm not sure if I can stick to the Hunger Games read along and read one book a month, because I really want to read Catching Fire very soon. Not straight away, it's not the next book that I've picked, but I do want to read it this month because, yeah, I'm completely in the Hunger Games mood and I want to continue with my reread. It was just wonderful and yeah, it's just amazing and I don't have anything else to say apart from it. Yeah, it's just one of my all-time favorite books and I love it so, so much. I will never get enough of it, but this reread in particular was very, very good. So yeah, that is something really, really nice. I'm happy that this book got me out of sort of like my reading crisis earlier this week, because this was just the perfect book for that. It was the perfect book for me to read at the time. Yeah, very happy with the choice. So yeah, very happy that I also didn't go down into a reading slump. I've avoided it, so very proud of that. So that is the first book that I finished this weekend. And then the second book, was Clockwork Angel. I finished the audiobook. And yeah, also don't have anything else to say about this one. It is very enjoyable, very entertaining. Yeah, I also like the audiobook, the narration, and yeah, I don't really have much to say about it. There is going to be a special Shadowhunter video very soon. I believe I mentioned that before. So there's going to be that, and in that one there's going to be a lot more reviews and things about the Shadowhunter books, so keep an eye out for that, and then I will talk more about the entire series. Yeah, don't know when it will be online yet. I want to do it sort of closely to the release date of Chain of Gold, or at least like a little bit before it. But yeah, there's going to be a special Shadowhunter video. If you like that content, then yeah, keep an eye out, or you know, subscribe or whatever. Just a little self promo right here. Yeah, Clockwork Angel is a really good one. Then after Clockwork Angel, I immediately continued with Clockwork Prince, also with listening to the audiobook. So I've listened to that this morning whilst getting ready, which is my usual audiobook ritual, just to listen to it whilst I'm making myself breakfast, getting dressed, doing my makeup and everything. It's just the best way to wake up and to start my day, at least in my opinion. So I've listened to a bit of Clockwork Prince. I'm now at page 71, so yeah, about an hour in or so. And with this one so far, I have the exact same thoughts as with Clockwork Angel. I think I like Clockwork Prince even a bit more. I think this book series really does get a bit better with each book. So yeah, this one is even better, and I do really love the characters and the relationships. I think that's the strongest point of the Infernal Devices series. I mean, there are also some amazing characters and relationships in the other Shadowhunter books, but with this one I just get so many feels and emotions, and I feel like everybody gets the attention they deserve. And also from the first book onwards, because like with the first Mortal Instruments books, not every character gets enough attention in my opinion, but with this book series it really is the case. Yeah, and I just really love it, and I'm just going to continue listen to this one. So that is it for my audiobook right now. But yeah, as I mentioned before, I also picked up a new physical book, and that is also one that I mentioned before in this reading vlog, but I decided, let me grab it. But I decided to pick up The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White. Yeah, I've talked about it before. This is the book of the month of February and March of the Midtake Reads book club, which is a book club that is all about books that are retellings or like inspired by mythology, and usually they are fantasy books. So this was the first of their Midtake Reads of the year, The Guinevere Deception. Also, as I mentioned before, it's a retelling of the King Arthur legend, and it's about Guinevere, but she's actually a changeling. She's not the real Guinevere, and she's on a mission to sort of, you know, go undercover in Camelot. I have read quite a bit of it actually. I'm now at page, what was it, 101? Yeah, 101. And so far, it does look promising. I think it's still too early to say if I'm going to like love it or not love it, I guess. But so far, there has been nothing that I really dislike about it. The story so far is intriguing. It's still very much at the start of it, and you know, with the world being explained and the characters being introduced and developed. Yeah, so far it does sound interesting and intriguing, and I hope it's going to be a good one. Personally, I don't think it's going to be a 5-star read. With a little bit of luck, it's going to be a 4-star one. I mean, I can never give a full review if I only read like the first 100 pages, but that's sort of like the ID so far. It's not going to be a new all-time favorite, because usually that, you know, like with picking it up instantly. But I think it's yeah, I'm just going to see. Maybe there's going to be something that I really dislike about it, because I've had that before, that I really liked the first half of a book, but then the second half was horrible and like not entertaining at all. But I really hope that isn't the case with The Guinevere Deception. So far it does seem promising, as I mentioned before. I really hope it's going to be like that for the rest of the book. Also, this is the first book in a book series I've discovered. I believe it's going to be a trilogy, the Camelot Rising trilogy. And yeah, I guess again I have to finish the book to find out if I want to continue with the series, but so far I'm having a good time reading it. Yeah, it is fun, you know. I don't read that many YA fantasy books anymore, but this one has an interesting premise and I do like that. Yeah, most of the books that I read now are either historical fiction or adult fantasy, or rereads of YA fantasy like the Infernal Devices series. I don't read that many new YA fantasy books yet. I don't know why. Maybe because a lot of them felt like they were going to be so similar to me. Like, it felt like a lot of the YA fantasy books were following a certain pattern that I didn't like all that much. Hard to explain, of course, not every YA fantasy book is the same, but I've like cut back a little bit on the YA fantasy genre, but it's nice to have one every once in a while again, and this one is interesting. And I think that's mainly because the premise is so different from what I would usually read. And overall, I do have some more YA fantasy on my TBR this month, and that's mostly with finishing book series, which needs to happen so desperately. So that's what I'm going to do after this, I guess. So yeah, I think that's mostly what I read right now. It's like adult fantasy, historical fiction, sometimes adult contemporary, not YA contemporary all that much, because I also don't like that all that much. Finishing book series and rereads of some of my favorites. That's sort of my like my reading schedule right now. Then for the rest of the day, I am going to work on school things that really need to happen. Unfortunately, because the train station at my like in my university town sort of isn't working this week, I can't go to university, and I don't need to go to university because I don't have any classes or lectures that I need to be. But I like to work in the university library because it's just, it feels like you're actually, you know, going to work or to school, even though I can do everything at home as well. It's just nice to be out of the house, you know, for a couple of days during the week. And also, when you're in the university library, you made the journey to there, which is like 45 minutes or so in total. And then it feels like a waste if you're not working and if you're not productive. So I'm sort of missing that this week. But yeah, I will manage because next week I can go back again. Also, something else, my next reading vlog is going to be a 24-hour readathon vlog, because this Saturday on the 15th of February, there's the next edition of the Basically Readathon, which is a readathon organized by my friend Brit over at Basically Brit. And she does these 24-hour readathons every once in a while. So my next reading vlog is going to be a vlog of that. So you have that to look forward to, hopefully next week. Very much looking forward to that as myself, you know, because I do love 24-hour readathons. And then, yeah, I think that is pretty much it for everything that I have to tell you, and I think that's pretty much it for this reading vlog. So yeah, I'm going to end this one, and yeah, as always, I really hope you enjoyed this reading vlog, and if you did, maybe go subscribe or give it a thumbs up, because that would really help my channel, and as always, I would really appreciate it, but of course only if you want to, of course. And then hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye!